So, nature, scope and importance of public policy, part 2. A public policy is crucial for the development process of a country and is basically a collective action for the fulfillment of needs and aspirations of the people at large. Following Sambo and Anderson, some basic elements differentiate public policy from private policies and other forms of policies. Public policy is a purposive course of action or goal-oriented action rather than a random or chance behavior. It involves spelling out of strategy and purposive actions to attain the objectives of the government with the ultimate aim of promotion of public interest. So, public policy is a goal-oriented or result-oriented action, and it involves spelling out of strategy and purposive actions to attain the objectives of the government in the ultimate aim of promotion of public interest. So public interest, promotion of public interest is the ultimate aim of every policy designed by the government. So it is goal-oriented and result-oriented. Public policy consists of courses of or patterns of action by government officials. So these the actions are taken by the government officials, but the policy is designed by the government, means the political system. Public policies are what governments actually do and not what they intend to do or say they are going to do. So policies are actually what they do is considered as policies, and however, but sometimes the government will say in future they will provide these facilities and they will bring some kind of policies, some kind of programs for the fulfillment of a particular area or a particular people or particular beneficiaries, etc. So government can declare their future plans, and in the future plans of governments over certain matters of concern can be seen as a commitment to resolving such issues within the set time. But this also from Sharkansky's position that a policy is also a proposal. Public policy has futuristic orientation. It is directed towards the future, which may be immediate or long term. Public policy involves some forms of overt government action to affect a particular problem. It involves a decision by government officials not to take action, to do nothing on some matter on which governmental involvement is required. Public policy has the sanction of law and authority behind it. Its legally coercive quality is accepted as lawful. For example, taxes must be paid unless one wants to run the risk of severe penalties or imprisonment. So, public policies has a sanction of law and authority behind it. So, it is a legitimate things. Public policies are legitimate things. And this quality of public policy makes it distinct from the policy of a private organization. Public policy is dynamic in the sense that it is continuously formulated and reformulated in response to the requirements of the environment and time. So, some policies are formulated and after implementing it, so many feedback, the government will get so many feedback from the people or the respondents or the beneficiaries, and after that they will modify the program, and later they reformulate it. So it's a dynamic process. So public policy is dynamic in the sense that it is continuously formulated and reformulated in response to the requirements of the environment and time. Public policy may be general or specific, broad or narrow, simple or complex, precise or implied, discretionary or exhaustive, and qualitative or quantitative. So these are the nature of public policy. It may be general or broad or simple or discretionary or specific, narrow, etc. And public policy may be positive or negative. Another characteristics of public policy is that it may be positive or negative. Positively, it depicts the concern of the government and involves obvious governmental action to deal with a particular issue. Negatively, it involves a decision by government officials regarding not taking action on a particular issue on which a governmental order is required. The negative aspect is that when some when related to some issues, the government officials do not take action on it, or taking action, they wanted the government order or government. It is considered as the negative aspect of the policy. Okay. Public policy can take diverse forms like laws, ordinance, court decisions, executive orders, administrative rules, and regulations. Public policies are various types. It may be deliberate, appealed, implied, externally imposed, value-laden, value-free, macro, micro, substantive, regulatory, distributive, and redistributive. Scope of public policy. It is necessary to understand the components of public policy in order to have a proper understanding of public policy. The scope and sheer size of the public sector has grown enormously, especially in developing countries, in response to the growing public needs and demands, and the increasing impacts of other trends such as the complexity of technology, social organization, industrialization, and urbanization. At present, functions of all governments in the developing countries have significantly increased. They are now concerned with the more complex functions of nation building and socio-economic progress. Today, the government is not merely the keeper of peace, the arbiter of disputes, and the provider of common goods and day-to-day services. It has directly or indirectly become the principal innovator, the major determinist of social and economic programs, and the main financier as well as the main catalyst for economic enterprise and development. A comprehensive understanding of the concept. Anderson observes some areas as the scope of public policy. They are policy demands, policy decisions, policy statements, policy outputs, and policy outcomes. Policy demands. Policy demands are demands or claims made upon public officials by other actors, private or official, in the political system for action or inaction on some perceived problem. Such demands may take the form of insistence that government ought to do something to a proposal for specific action on the matter. Policy decisions are decisions made by public officials that authorize or give direction and content to public policy actions. Example, a decision to enact statute, issue executive orders or edicts, promulgate decrees, etc. Policy statements. Policy statements are, according to Anderson, are the formal expressions or articulation of public policy. They include legislative statutes, decrees, presidential orders, administrative rules, and court opinions indicating the intentions and goals of government and the ways and means of realizing them. It is important to mention that policy statements are sometimes ambiguous and conflicting. They are sometimes conflicting in the sense that different and contradictory policy statements may be issued by different levels, branches or units of government on a particular problem. Policy outputs, according to Anderson, are tangible manifestation of policies or the things actually done in pursuance of policy decisions and statements. They are therefore what government does as distinguished from what it says it will do. In response to the demands and claims made, governmental officials take policy decisions that provide direction and content to policy actions. These actions produce effects on the environment which are regarded as policy outputs. David Easton regards that outputs are said to constitute a body of specific instruments for the members of a political system to support it, either by threats of sanctions, rewards for support given, or by socialization into the political norms of the society. Policy outcomes refers to the real results produced. They indicate the actual impact on the target group. Policy outcomes are the consequences, intended or unintended, for society that results from action or inaction by government. The intended consequences of the current privatization policy being implemented in India are efficiency and high profit of the privatized firms, removal of government subsidies of public enterprises, thereby saving crores of rupees worth of public funds over the years, etc. But the unintended consequences are inflation and the consequent hardship for families due to low purchasing power of people. Again, the capitalization policy and the policy of merging of banks being currently implemented by the RBI may achieve the intended consequences of strengthening the banks, thereby securing public funds, but it may lead to cutback of workers of banks. The range of public policy is vast, that is from vital to trivial. Today, public policy may deal with such substantive areas as defense, environment, environment protection, medical care and health, education, housing, taxation, inflation, science and technology, and so on. The relevance of public policy in the administration of state can be summed up in the following terms. It's a mirror that guides government in its actions. This is because government without a definite plan of actions is like a traveler without a destination. Public policy thus helps government to reconcile the numerous public demands and scarce resources based on priority. It arouses in citizens' public consciousness and critical minds to take up the challenge of assessing government planned activities and performance over time. It provides the platforms to question the why of government. Why do governments or what they do? It seeks an understanding of the causes or determinants of political policy actions. It provides the opportunity for various interest groups and the general public to know government's responses and reaction to their demands. Such reactions show the pattern of action governments adopts or intends to adopt. It promotes professionalism in the art and science of policy making, applying the knowledge of social science to solve practical societal problems makes it compelling that expertise contributions of political scientists or public development administrators, economists, sociologists, lawyers, industrial relations experts, among others, are sought in analyzing the viability and feasibility of proposed policies that have direct consequences on the general populace, the economy, and government itself. Since the state has come to be perceived as an active agent in promoting and shaping societies in its various dimensions, public policies expanded their scope from merely one of regulation to that of promoter, development, and enterprise. Public policy is a significant part of any political system. They are dynamic and key factors for the success of any form of governments. Although the subject is of recent origin, it has incorporated many refinements in the conceptual and methodological apparatus, thereby enabling it to meet the requirements of theoretical depth and analytical rigor. Thank you.